To kick things off, I just have a few, a 10-minute talk about work we did, not yesterday, but the 2 days before that, at Codefest in Orlando. So just to sort of, what is Codefest? So this is a two-day working session we do before BOSC. It's, you know, it's completely free, and the idea is to get together people from the community and to learn about things we're doing, train new people to get involved with the community, to build existing relationships amongst everyone who's been in the community. And practically, we write code and talk. Everyone is very welcome, whether you've contributed or not to anything. If you're just interested, we're very happy to have you. This is the 7th year in a row we've done it, which is kind of amazing. The way Codefest works is it's free. You just can show up. There's a pretty simple, like Google, there's a spreadsheet, add your name and you can come, that's it. And what we try to do is just kind of give you the basics so that you need to live, right? Like wireless and power and food and coffee, and that's it. And then we try to get together and work. So what we do is everyone sort of talks about the things that they're interested in, and we self-organize around projects that people want to work on, and then we get to work. And the idea is to produce useful code and also motivation. It's fun to work with people. And then afterwards we talk about what we did, which is this slide here. And I just like to, you know, before I go into sort of some of the things that we did in those 2 days, to give you a feel for what's been happening, just want to say thank you to FamiLab. They're a local hackerspace in Orlando, sort of north of the city. And they're awesome. I don't have any connection with them at all, but I just sent them an email and was like, would you guys want to host us for a couple of days? And they said that would be awesome. And they actually, people from FamiLab came and worked with us. And so I have some stuff that they did, which is really cool. And especially Dave Casey and Mike Liu helped us sort of organize the logistics and where she get food and coffee and all those sort of things. And I'd like to thank Cureverse and PLOS because they gave us money so we'd have food and coffee, which is very helpful. And thank you to the community for showing up. I'm always say, organize this stuff, and these are especially weird where I like never saw the place and I'd have never been to North Altamonte before, and I'm always half afraid that the place won't exist and half afraid that like I'll show up and no one else will show up and I'll look like I'm insane, and so I'm glad everything worked out again. And so just kind of go through some of the projects that we worked on real quick. These slides will be available so you can really read in the details, and on the Codefest website, which is linked at the beginning, there's also detailed information about what people did if you're curious. You know, I think I'll start off with sort of, there was a lot of talks about this yesterday, the common workflow language. That's a cool one because it's a sort of a child of Codefest. You know, it was thought about, it was like just an idea in people's minds 2 years ago in a discussion. And now this year they had the 1.0 release and finished that up. And there were a ton of people there working on it. Michael, who talked yesterday, was, and Peter were kind of leading a lot of the stuff up, and all seven bridges were there. And Jessica was also involved, so it was great to see so many people working on that. Another group that was there as well was the Spark and the Adam team, really. Spark, Adam should be first before Spark here, so I can read it. But they're like a distributed group, so it's actually a cool chance for them to get together and work in the same place. And they were very productive on that. And Matt and John also pitched in and learned how to get Adam working with Python, which was pretty useful. So it was cool to see other people getting involved with Adam as well. And there's nice representation from the Nextflow project. I think Paulo has a poster about that as well here. And they kind of worked with the Adam folks as well, trying to sort of fit in Nextflow with Adam. And I think this is a really cool, these are the really cool things that happen at Codefest, is trying to bring different communities and projects together. You know, and that's something that we've been emphasizing a lot. And of course, there were also people from sort of existing the BioStar projects, which is sort of the origin of OpenBio. Spencer and Joe were there doing BioJava structural visualization, which is awesome because we have pretty graphics to show. So they were ripping out a bunch of old Java stuff and making it JavaScript and fancy and Web 2.0 and other awesome things like that. The BioPro folks were there as well. This is really depressing because your pictures didn't show up, Chris. Oh man, he has pictures of old people on this and completely random old people he found on the internet. And because apparently you have to be old to write Perl now, I didn't know. Chris and Homar worked really hard on getting out a 1.7.0 release of File Pearl and also getting it working in Docker. And Hannes was there adding in phylogenetic inference wrappers as well. So it's cool to see that work. You have an animation? Wow. It's awesome. This is when someone else makes your slide deck. When like 20 different people make the slide deck, you get some random things happening. So that's a big surprise, those old people showing up right there. It's pretty sweet. Look at and we were also doing BioPython work as well. Christian was leading that up, did a bunch of work on Pepe fixing things and was working with Peter, which is pretty cool. I think he was like probably on the plane on the way here. Via GitHub working on that. There was some BC Bio work that Chris was also working on, and Rory, who's in, not in Boston, Connecticut, was working on that with him, fixing up things as well. So it was really cool to see all those projects sort of working, both people internally and remotely who couldn't make it here. There were also some cool sort of people did a really good job this year of having projects that were self-contained that you could do within the time frame. When I initially thought of Codefest and the idea was like, oh, people are working on projects already, we can get together and work. But a cool thing that's have sort of developed as a community is people are like, I want to come in and be part of the community. I want to do something in 2 days. What's a project I can do? And so Ben came up with this project to work on extracting code from PubMed abstracts, and John was interested in working on it. And so they were able to make good success in 2 days about parsing out all these code repos from PubMed, and you'll be happy to know that a lot of them are GitHub now, and they got 700, 800, I forget the numbers, and like 10 were no longer live. I thought that was pretty actually impressive change from what I would have expected, where 50% of them are someone's academic website that no longer exists. So it's cool progress to see as well. The other project that was a really good success in terms of bringing new people in the community was MultiQC. So this is a project from Phil Ewells, who's in SciLife Lab in Sweden. He couldn't be there, but he was actually online for a lot of it, helping people. And Lorena had come up with a nice list of ideas for things to plug in. And MultiQC is a really nice project because it's broken up into specific small parts, and so you can plug in individual parts. So what we were able to do is get a lot of people involved who were just looking for a project to do. So Heather was a good example of that. And then Mike Liu, whose stuff is on the next page, which I think is especially worth highlighting, he's a FamiLab member, so he never really heard of us or not anything we were talking about, right? He's just interested in building stuff and was interested in biology, and so came and was able to contribute some extraction from Picard about base distributions and put that in, which I thought was pretty sweet, and he was super excited to be involved with the community as well. So I think that's a really sort of cool outcome of this that I would not have been good at doing. So I'm really, really appreciative to the community for sort of developing this ability to like to bring in new members. And hopefully that's something we can kind of emphasize in new year in upcoming years. And I think there was a lot of talk at the panel about sort of the power of being able to engage new people. And so that's definitely something we're going to be working on as well. And another awesome thing so FamiLab is like this giant, they have a lot of fabrication stuff as well. And Dave was one of the ones who was hosting us. And so he was learning from people about projects and also working on this like syringe pump, which was pretty impressive. They're doing like 3D printing of these things. And they're really cool guys. They have a bunch of cool hacks. And so they have stuff they bought, and then there's parts that are really expensive. So they were 3D printing those. So he built some cool things while we were there and was showing us how the 3D printer works, which is pretty impressive. So just to conclude, I just want to, say thank you to the Open Bioinformatics community. This is a nice picture from Robin that shows what happens, which is just a bunch of people in a room working, which is really sort of all Codefest is in the end. But it was really cool to have everyone together, another really fun year. And if you are thinking about coming to Codefest and want to know more about it, please feel free to come talk to me or, anyone on these slides can tell you what it's like. So thanks very much, and I'll get things going with the people you want to hear this morning. Cool, thanks.